No, the move that Karpov was so unhappy with. Queen e8. He felt this was a critical error. Does the champion share his opinion on this move?
Knight takes h6.
So he did not see this move?
I didn't calculate it. I knew that it should won.
I saw you playing very quickly this move.
I didn't calculate. I saw several lines. Why it's winning? Because I have seven pieces in the attack. Two bishops, two knights, two rooks, and rooks is attacked to queen. He has some pieces protected, okay? Rook, two pawns, and bishop, and maybe queen. Okay, we can change, you know? It's an equal change. I change one attacking piece for one defensive piece, but I have enough pieces to make him.
So, let's have a look. Knight
takes. H6, he played c3, you know?
And now, this bishop. Why didn't he take?
Okay, if he takes here, it's very nice. I took knight takes d6. Now I can show you many good, interesting lines. Number one, if he's trying to escape with him, queen d7. Then I played queen g4. If he takes here, then bishop takes d7, mate.
So bishop takes?
Bishop takes, queen takes.
This is mate.
Mate, yes. If he takes...
If he takes your queen
with
now?
With a rook, wait a second, yes. Then check. And if he cannot...
Because of
because
check.
Check, and this is spinned, the pawn is spinned. And the king g8 is a mate in several moves. Bishop h7, bishop g6, and queen h7, mate. If he takes my queen, then it's a very nice combination. Check, the only move. Check, check, king f7, bishop g6, check, king g8, the only moves. Bishop f5, bishop e6, king g8, bishop takes e5, check, and bishop takes b7.
And so you have a nice investment, which is a rook up after,
yeah, rook
all
up after all
this combination.
Yes, and but it's not the end of the story. Actually, this line I saw at the board, but some other I found after. It proved that I was right, you know. In this position, he could go on queen h5. Here I played rook g5. You cannot take here because knight f7 check and take the queen. If you take here, it's interesting, you know.
Knight check.
Check, king h8. Rook takes d1 and c3. And it looks very good for black because it's now the pawn is closed. Bishop is hanging, c2 is threatening. But suddenly, knight f7 check, king d8, bishop g6. C takes b2, rook h5.
And
there is no defense.
Wonderful.
It's a mate. Again, mate.
It's wonderful.
It's mate again.
You had the feeling for this position.
The feeling, yes. And final, I can show you the final. If he sacrificed queen, I mean, just in this position. If he sacrificed queen by playing queen takes e1, rook takes d6. Then I played queen e4. Threatening mate, knight d3, queen h4 check, king g8, bishop takes g7, and queen g4.
And no defense.
No
the rook
defense.
Cannot defend because queen takes.
Queen takes, and that's all.
And this is over. All the pieces are disconnected.
Yes, absolutely. And I don't mean Karpov saw it, but he felt that this is bad. He didn't take my knife.
He was confident in your calculations or in your feeling.
Maybe in my feelings.
He was just confident.
He tried to close this bishop, you know. It's fine, but now this bishop is a very strong suited.
So first of all, you gave one piece. Now you're sacrificing another piece.
Yeah, another piece. Okay, he killed this bishop. But this bishop now, he cannot close it anymore.
And he gave you some tempi, which is important in chess.
Yes, absolutely. And I still have six pieces.
So six instead of seven, this is not a big loss.
But no, there's no pawn, you know?
But one defender less, as you said before. So instead of five, now four defenders.
Yes, and it's not enough. He played bishop c8, trying to
have some play.
Queen h4 check. Yes. If he goes king g8, then simply king h2, and no defense, and knight g5.
Knight g5, and then queen h7.
And mate.
Yes. Mate.
He's trying to stop me. Rook h6, take, king h2.
Very strong move.
An important move, you know. Just now my knight can go, because rook is hanging without check. Queen e5, knight g5, king f6, queen f6, rook e8. Now I have only five pieces in attack, but you know, just three defenders left. And it's just five very powerful.
So it was 7-5, 6-4, and now 5-3.
5-3, yes. 5-3, yes.
Anyway. Still, the proportion is still very
difficult. Yeah, but 5-3 is much more dangerous than 7-5. You know? And, for instance, any move If we got bishop b7 here, then it says I have the same combination, but mate.
Immediately.
He made the only move just to avoid the mate in three, but anyway, it's here I play. This is very nice move. Queen takes h6.
This is fantastic, because in a world championship, it is very unusual to have queen sacrifices.
Yes, queen sacrifices. Yes, this is true. Queen takes h6, knight f7 check. Queen d6, and here it's unforgivable mistake, you know, you should take with zero. Yeah, I know, but I just wanted to take all his pieces, you know, from the board.
Because after rook take g6,
it's a mate.
You would mate him just by removing the rook next move.
Yes, this is true. Knight e7, then I took on e7, bishop takes e7, and rook g,
and rook
mate.
Here, checkmate, because no square for the king, and it is mated with the bishop.
Yeah, unfortunately, this bishop could... Okay, I took his queen with the bishop.
And I think the rest is just...
Okay, I have an extra rook again.
We are now about to witness the magic of Garry Kasparov. The world champion checks his calculations. It's really important to be accurate at a time like this. He has to restrain himself. Clearly, Kasparov's very excited here. One last check. Now the incredible move. Queen takes h6, sacrificing the queen. The time control's reached, and Kasparov lends Karpov his score sheet to copy up. And Karpov concedes. What an incredible game by Garry Kasparov.